Pepsi has something to say about the look at the this thing called this the arrest of commissioner Dr. Nomsa Masuku. They have something to say about that. So in an official statement, they have said something. EFF has got something to say as well that I think it's worth your ears and your attention. EFF released a letter. We're going to read the one from IEC saying that we're going to read the one from IEC as well. But they're talking about the same thing, by the way. EFF statement. No. The one that I've just opened now, it's not the one that I'm looking for. Just give me a few minutes as I go through the statement released on the 21st of... Yes, this is one. EFF statement on the charges against the IEC Commissioner Nomsa Masuku. Friday, 21st of June, 2024. Economic Freedom Fighter EFF have taken note of the recent charges against the IEC Commissioner and former Standard Bank employee, Nomsa Masuku. According to report, Masuku was arrested on Friday morning by the Hawks for allegedly committing 1.2 million in fraud relating to student and scholarship and bursaries. Well, hey, my daughter, I've got a problem that when people are saying our surname, they always butcher our surname. Look, whenever I walk into a space, so and then they ask me, what's your name? I tell them, what's your surname? I tell them, Masuku. Masuku! Even Africans, you know, I'm talking about black Africans, they've got a problem of butchering our surnames. I'm interested to hear them pronouncing my surname there, because Masuku is my surname. So I'm interested to hear them pronouncing my surname there. Masuku. Masuku. Oi, Masuku. Masuku. Hey, man. Masuku. Masuku. Oi, boo. Hey, wena. But that's not where we are. We'll talk about it. But before we proceed talking about it, wait, you mean we are celebrating 50 subscribers and you want to be left on the other side? You don't want to join these people? You don't think, don't you think 50,000 people saw it fit that, you know what, this channel is interesting. This channel is beautiful. We must follow this channel. Don't you think you should be doing the same thing? It surprises me that if I were to borrow your money, you wouldn't. If I were to borrow your car, you wouldn't. If I were to borrow your children, you wouldn't. Your property, you wouldn't. Your cell phone, you wouldn't. Your everything that belongs to you, you wouldn't borrow me. But when I ask you to do this, which is free, just this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so I'm gonna end with the one year IEC responding to this, right? Let's start with the one year EFF. The charges stem from her time as a head of Adopt School Trust, a corporate social investment program at Standard Bank. Hawks investigators have reportedly found that Masuku manipulated the processes of trust by awarding scholarships to friends and family members without approval of the committee, and some of the funds were allegedly deposited directly into her personal bank account. This accusation comes after a highly sensitive time following a recent election where there have been significant public concern concerns about the fairness and the integrity of the electoral process. Such allegations cast a shadow over the IEC, further erode public trust in a democratic institution. When I remember I saw a comment, somebody says, hey, this is not related. I'm like, when a clever black. I told them that the fact that this person is arrested in something that that she's been accused of, like corruption, bribery, right? Remember Inja Jabenguni complaining about something like that. For the fact that now you get charged to something along those lines, hey, it says something, but let's proceed. Furthermore, EFF hopes that the investigation was not, present during the time she was appointed as IEC commissioner, as it puts into question the preliminary processes of selecting commissioners and their due diligence. If such oversight occurred, it will present a serious dishonoring of our constitution and the values it upholds. It is essential that those appointed to such critical positions are thoroughly vetted to prevent any potential breach of trust and integrity. I get where the EFF is coming from. Like, I honestly get where EFF is coming from. They hope that if she was appointed still a commissioner, knowing that there were such investigations against her. But let's finish later. To preserve its integrity, to preserve integrity of the IEC and ensure public confidence in our democratic processes, the EFF expected Masugu to already resign from her position. If Masugu were truly committed to the constitution and the principles of democracy she professes to uphold as a commissioner, she will step down. This resignation will allow her to address these serious allegations personally without further tarnishing the reputation of IEC. It is imperative that the IEC is above reproach, upholding the principle of free and fair elections. You know, I wouldn't have said it better. Let's go back to the IEC itself. In an official statement, IEC, I need IEC, not you. Ramaphosa angazufuna la. Ngithi ngifuna IEC uyasondela, ngithi hayi Ramaphosa mina ngifuna wena. Why wena uzovela la, mina ngifuna wena. Ngifuna IEC. Manje sengifuna IEC, guys. IEC iyabaleka la computer manje. Ngiyabafuna banamanga ngizosifunda statement sapho. Ningakhathazeki nina. Ehhe. Is it not? It's not this one. Hey guys, uyabona manje ke I have the state nas, yeah. Manje people they will say you are disorderly bongani. Kanti the statement is here. Phela there are many files here wena guys. Now lalelani ke guys ngicoxe indaba ningayazi. IEC bona bathi media statement 21st of June 2024. Electoral Commission responds to a matter of the reported arrest of Commissioner Dr. Nomsa Masugu. The Electoral Commission is aware of the reported arrest of Commissioner Dr. Nomsa Masugu. It appears that the matter relates to her elsewhere employment and does not relate to her tenure in the IEC Commission, both as an employee and as a commissioner. The commission will monitor the development in the matter. That's all they wanted to tell us, that they will monitor the matter, this thing. They are not telling us about the integrity of the IEC. They are not telling us why she needs to resign. No, they are just telling us that they will monitor the situation. They decided to take their time just to write a statement that we are monitoring the situation. What are we supposed to do with that when there's a question about the integrity there's a question about everything that you guys are doing at IEC. What are we supposed to do about it? You see what I'm trying to say? Nevertheless, guys, you and I will meet each other in the next video. I do wish that you subscribe, you like the video, and you click the notification bell. Why? So that when I post the next video, you will be the first to be notified. Till such a time, good people, please take care.